Cutting a roll of tatami with my katanasforsale.com katana while wearing my Iron Mountain Armory Taisho class armor in this video. That was my first time cutting wearing samurai armor. I was pretty happy I was able to complete the cuts. I haven't cut tatami in about 3 years, and because of not cutting for so long, I started soaking the mat and I got distracted. Accidentally soaked it for 6 days. You're actually supposed to soak it for about 24 hours, and I was so excited to get to cutting something, I pulled it out, shook it dry, put it on the stand and cut it. Normally you want to give it about a half hour to dry out a little bit. I could feel some drag as I was doing the cuts. I did complete them, but in a very perfect cut, you won't feel anything from the sword. I'm not sure if that drag was over soaking the mats, if it's because I haven't cut in 3 years and my technique wasn't quite right, or if it's because of the edge on the sword, that is the factory edge on the sword. I have not touched it in any way. Could be a combination of all three of those. Not really sure what the cause was, but still enjoy doing it. I think I'm gonna go back and try refining the edge a little bit and see if that makes a difference on it, as well as soaking the tatami for the proper amount of time and drying it the proper amount of time as well. Once I get back into the armor again, I also wanna do some tatami cutting with the odachi, with a large sword. I think that's gonna be real interesting. I haven't actually cut tatami with one with or without armor yet, so that's gonna be a really fun experience. Even though the kote were sagging, I didn't notice any real impact on my cutting technique for that. I'm not sure if that's because I have not perfect technique for that, but really at the end of the day, who's perfect? So maybe my technique is just a little bit off, so I don't notice the impediment on that. It may be that it didn't slide down all the way and has only moved a little bit. The forearms remained tight, so it wasn't affecting anything in my outward swings like this. It was only maybe a little bit of drag up here. I'm used to fighting in European armor that weighs twice as much as this, so I didn't really notice any difference with the weight for that. I also saw in the video where the kote were sliding around on the hands a little bit, drawing a blank on the term for the back of the hand plate there, but it has two loops on it. Those loops are loose on me, however, I have not tightened them down because I have some Yugake gloves on order from Iron Mountain Armory, and I want to wait until I get the gloves before I tighten up the loops on that, because if I tighten it up for without wearing the gloves, it's going to be too tight for with them, so I think that'll resolve the problem for that. This is the first video that I've done with the new GoPro camera. I think the slow motion turned out really nice for that, so I'm pretty excited about that. I do intend to use that for any of my upcoming videos that have cutting in them. I think it's a really nice way not only to see what's happening as I cut through things, but for me to review my own technique and see how I'm doing, whether it's good, whether it's bad, if there's any room for improvement, noticing any of the little subtle differences. Tatami is a fantastic feedback medium, because you can see as you cut through, if you cut down, if you cut up, if you stopped cutting through, if you cut too short, it tells you many of those things for the cut. But one thing it does not tell you is your body structure throughout the cut. You can't see if you've overextended the cut. Those sort of things are very difficult to self-assess for that unless you have the video for it. So this is very much a tool for myself as much as it is a chance to share something with you all here on YouTube. I really enjoy doing it. I definitely want to continue doing so. I'll also be doing some cutting of milk jugs and water bottles, things of that nature, in some of my other videos because, as I mentioned, the tatami is pretty expensive and I want to do a lot of cutting, so gotta do what you gotta do and what you can afford. One thing I do want to mention is while this may be my first time cutting tatami in the samurai armor, I have actually cut tatami before in medieval armor a few times. Medieval Europeans, such as a knight, would actually wear. So while this was my first time with the samurai, it's not my first time in armor. If you try it the first time, your experiences might be a little bit different. I've spent 10 years in armor, so I'm used to how it moves and affects things. So this certainly would not be reflective of someone's first time picking up a sword, putting on armor, and trying to cut. I did have a benefit to that, so I just want to make sure that that's known. I'll have some upcoming videos where I will be doing some close-up shots of the swords and the armor, so keep an eye out for those in the next few weeks.